So we are now recording and it will be streamed in the internet then. So Sojourn BC from Nepal, where are you, Sojourn? Please show your photo. Ah, Yvonne is there. Hello, Yvonne. Nice to meet you.
Hi, Raul. Hi.
Yeah, Sojourn. Please, can you turn on your photo? Is it possible?
Okay, so just a minute.
So Navdeep also, is possible to take a video from you?
Yes. Hi, everyone.
There is your holy. Hello, Navdeep. I see there is your young astronaut beside you.
So. Oh, yes, I do have my young astronauts beside me, yeah.
Okay, this is nice. You see a lot of people now. Yeah? My name is Ralf. So we are waiting for more applicants now. But first, I want to introduce you a very interesting band, a music band for electronic music. They want to make a small live concert for us today. This is the Cosmic Noise Crew. Hello to the Cosmic Noise Crew. Where are you? Can you see him? Can you all see Cosmic Noise Crew? Okay. So,
yes,
start your concert. You have 5 more minutes and then we start with our conversation. Okay? 5 minutes. Come on.
Okay.
Cosmic Noise Radio.
I think we hear something. Hello. Very nice. It's not a little, it was a little bit low, the audio, but in the future we will have more from the Cosmic Noise Crew, because they make electronic music for 3 minutes of space. And this is what we all are doing for. And this is for our new, also our new future, that we have a crew, a band behind us, where we want to use to go on tour worldwide. So we have some new people here. Hello, Shafi. Shafi, how are you doing?
Hello, sir. How are you? I'm good. I'm very good. Oh,
nice to meet you. What is the temperature in East India now?
No, actually, I am in USA, New Hampshire. So it's 4 degrees Celsius. Yeah.
Okay, so you come to Germany. Germany, that's also 4 degrees now.
Yeah, I will do that.
So this is Shafi from Chennai. He is now in New Hampshire, in the USA. Congratulations to you. And so we have Surgeon BC. Hello. You're looking nice, like a robot surgeon from Nepal.
Hi, Ralph. Hi, everyone. How are you doing? I'm doing this good in Kathmandu.
Exactly 2 years ago, we met us by the Ministry of Education.
Yes.
Kathmandu,
Yes.
Okay. Welcome to join our first meeting. This is for a press conference. We want to speak about student challenges and their skills in the future. So you have everyone from our team here. We have Jasleen. Hello, Jasleen. How are you doing?
Hi, Jasleen.
Good. Hi. How are you?
Yeah, Jasleen, a little bit louder that we can hear you.
Hear me now?
Yes, very nice. Please.
Okay.
So, Jasleen, maybe you are the first. You are in our Space Education Institute since 2015. Your team had a winning prize. It was a winning team in this year at the NASA Rover Challenge. And tell me something, or tell us something about what you are doing now.
Okay, yeah, sure. So I am working on a project. It's a space architecture project with the Boeing, where we are designing a spacecraft for their 2024 mission. So we are designing a rover as well as like a habitat for them. That's the work that I'm doing right now. It's a NASA as well as the Boeing combined project.
Great. I'm very proud of you.
Thank you.
Jasleen. Tell me from where you are and how long are you living in the USA now?
Sure. Yeah. So I'm from India, Haryana, Kurukshetra, but I'm in US since 2015. I came here in 2014, but now permanently here since 2014, I'm since here. And currently I'm in Houston, Texas.
Houston, Texas now. Yeah. So we have no problem. You are fine there.
Exactly. Yeah.
Thank you, Jasleen. Everyone who has a question, only take his hand up to Jasleen, and you will get the permission to can talk with her. But first, we want to start more. One moment, Surgeon. First, we want to introduce our whole round. There is Jesco and Tara. Hello, Jesco and Tara. How are you? You must mal auf das Mikrofon drücken, Tara. So, jetzt. Hallo nochmal. Can we hear you? Hello, Jesco, Tara. Okay, that's fine. These are my kids. And Jesco is now one of the most skilled CAD designer on SolidWorks. It is really. He cannot read German books, but he can work with the English designer software. This is amazing. Yeah. Jesco, vielleicht holst du mal was aus deinem 3D-Drucker und zeigst es denen. Okay? So Jesco want to pick up something. So we have time to say hello to Firine. Firine, our first pilot from 2019. And until now, she is currently the champion of the NASA Rover Challenge on the course. And hello, Firine, how are you doing?
Hi, I'm fine.
Tell me something about you, how you entered the Space Education Institute and what you did in all the past 5 years with us.
So I'm part of the ESA since 2016, I think, so quite a long time. Actually, I just wanted to sleep in Leipzig because we picked the space hotel because it's like friendly to the environment and everything. And then Ralf sat at the reception, and that's how I got to the institute. Yeah. And I participated in that weekend. We sold it something, I think, with Cosmo together. And yeah, I was part of the wheel design team and the front driver in the last year. And the telemetry is also kind of my specialization.
Great. Thank you, Firine. So who else want to ask Firine questions after our introduction? The next is Sorjan. You want to say something again, maybe a short introduction for everyone, because you are new. Only we saw you in the past, or we saw us, but all the other are new for you and you are new for them. Please, your short introduction.
Hi, everyone. This is Sorjan Bishi from Kathmandu, Nepal. I've been working for the STEM education for last almost 5 years. And I'm the founder, chairperson of the STEM Foundation Nepal. So currently I'm working with the Ministry of Education, Science and Technology to execute the STEM education in Nepal. And we just introduced STEM education in the National Education Policy of Nepal just a year ago. And now we have been successful to keep this STEM education in the National Planning Commission as a game changer as well. So we are working on the framework of STEM education execution plan right now. And we are really excited to train our teachers and the students on this robotics, automation, this space education, and so on. And this for the upcoming innovative generation in Nepal. So it's really a pleasure to see you all, the young innovators and the professionals in this forum. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Ralf.
Thank you very much. I forgot there is somebody who knows you and who you know, because he was with us together, with me together in the Ministry of Nepal of Education. This is Navdeep. Navdeep, hello. Nice to see you. And please, your introduction for everyone.
Yeah. Hi,
Navdeep. Yeah. Hello. My name is Navdeep, and I'm from India. So we're working since 2014, and we are working as a partner, as a student.
Okay, now I understand that his internet connection is broken. We were working on this problem because Navdeep is one of our best students. I cannot say student because he's one of the best teacher. And he is now building the Space Tower India. This is a bigger copy than the Space Education Institute of Germany, a 5-story building in India, in Kurukshetra, what is 150 in north of Delhi. And he's in construction now of this building. And I hope we will see in the next days some of his photos, because he told me that he is now ready with building and everything should be now inside, furniture, skin and wall and paper and paint and everything. So I'm very surprised that this is impossible, that it is possible to build a school after that, what we are doing here, and with all this experience and with all this motivation of Indians who are joining now Moon, Mars and the space. This is really, we see Jasleen here, and we see also, we know also that India made a moon landing in the past. Only 1 meter was missing, but this will come in the future too. Yes, okay. So we have more students to introduce now. Cosma, please introduce yourself.
So, hello, my name is Cosma. I'm 13 years old and I'm here in the International Space Education Institute. And I will be the pilot for 2022. Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Cosma. for 2022, this was important because in 2021 will be no international participation possible. We also scrapped this because by this counts of corona infections and by the travel ban, what is still existing, it is not possible to make any travel to the USA with a safe, with the safety, with the core values, with health, and also with the papers, what you need by visa and everything else. So we save our energies and we prepare that what we are doing now for next challenges, what will be also the ESAI Rover Challenge in Leipzig in fall next year. And you will get all information soon. This will be an innovation congress, include a Rover Challenge after our mains and our ideas. So for everyone who cannot drive so far, who cannot fly so far to the USA, can do this also here in Germany under the umbrella of Jesko von Puttkamer's tracks. Okay, I want to introduce also my best side, what is my wife. This is Yvonne. Since 9 years, we are friends in Facebook, but since 19 years, we are friends as a peer. And since 15 years, we married. We have 3 kids, all of them you saw now. Here is the littlest one here, Jesko, hello. And he wants to show his 3D prints now, but first introduce Yvonne. Yvonne, please.
Hello, everybody. I'm Yvonne, and maybe you hear about from me. So I'm also in the International Space Education Institute since the beginning, and yes, I was not a driver, I'm only was an organization to help all to get it fine. Okay.
Thank you, Yvonne. Yvonne is one of our longest member here. She founded the Space Education Institute with 7 other people and Jesko von Puttkamer. Also one of our oldest international member is Alina from Bolivia. Hello, Alina, how are you doing? Please introduce yourself. So I think, Alina, you must turn on your microphone and you get a permission from our advisor.
Hi, hi everyone. Can you hear me? I'm sorry, I was in another meeting. I'll turn on my camera in a moment, but hi everyone, it's nice to see you.
We all are fine, Alina. We are now in a circle to introduce everyone by himself. So please introduce yourself and what you are doing now. You are with us also since 2015, summer, as a summer camp, and then in the NASA since 2016. Tell us something about your time with us and what you are doing now.
Okay, now? Okay, I was part of ESAI since 2015. I attended the summer camp. I was the first Bolivian participating in the NASA Rover Challenge in 2016. And then with ESAI, I participated in 2017 and 2019. Currently, I'm studying mechatronic engineering in Vaughan College in New York, United States, and I am doing some interesting activities here, like some projects. I'm part of some clubs as well, so I'm really interested in working in the aerospace field in the future, but I really like the fact that I can combine aerospace and ecology. So that's what my like ultimate goal.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Alina, thank you. You are one of our most interested power women in our team. And behind her are now 4 teams from Bolivia, so that the national restriction is now turning on. But this is what I want to say to you. We are working on fair rules for future international teams. we hope that after the Trump administration, it will be possible, because in the last 4 years, a lot of things were worse in this acceptance, what Jesco von Puttkammer and me and Yvonne started to build up for international teams. Let's see what will be possible. It will be fair to have same rules for every team. In a moment, it's not so. So that's why we started also the ESI Rover Challenge under the Innovation Congress in Germany, that you can try to test yourself, but it will be a different challenge with other goals. So we have now 4 minutes left. Here is one new friend in our team. This is Chu Juan. So now we are going to Spain and to Mexico, to the Spain language. I want to introduce you, our administrator, what works for the International Space Education Institute, and the instructor for our CAT units. This is this is our Valeria. Valeria, please introduce yourself, and Juan also from UNAC after that.
Okay, so hello everybody. I am Valeria from Mexico. I am currently studying aeronautical manufacturing engineering in Mexico, in Querétaro. And I met Ralph because of the NASA Rover Challenge, which I was participating in 2019 in Mexico, and he came to the university. And I'm working for the Institute as CAT instructor and designer, and also responsible for 3D printing.
Great, thank you. This is very nice. She is now in Leipzig, Germany. First, before we hear Juan and all our team members, what we have now, I need to make a screenshot for the German press now. So please smile, look into the camera, and one moment, I will press the button just now. Everything fine, or should we take it again? Okay, we want make one again. 3, 2, 1, cheese! So this looks nice. This is normal, so we try to test. We see now how what is possible at this video conference with Zoom. So we have 40 minutes limit in the moment. We want to extend it in the future. So our first 40 minutes were over because we made a lot of settings now. So we are waiting for Felipe. And Felipe is here. Yes, Felipe is nice. Okay. Then I wait for the next recording. It will be in 5 minutes. Then we can record it again. Yvonne is here. The next, Ralf Heckel, without my face, this is a computer, what I have here for recording our video conferences, so that we can share it in the internet, WhatsApp, Facebook, and so on. Yeah? So Juan, you are from the UNAC. Yeah, we know us from last year. It was the last possible moment what we had last year, that I made this round trip, also to Querétaro. Very nice city, but I seen anything from her. I seen nothing because I had not so much time. I hope it will be in the future better. Let us look now if we are. We can record again. So then I will start the button for recording now. And Sergeant, please introduce yourself. No, Juan. Yeah.
Okay. Many thanks, Ralph. Yes, that was the before the pandemic, all the COVID stuff. So hello, everyone. I am Juan Pablo from Mexico. I'm now the current team leader from Roche team. One of the international teams of NASA Human Rover Exploration Challenge. And I'm currently studying the same career as Valeria, engineering in manufacturing.
Thank you, Juan. I understand that Querétaro and also the UNAC are very nice places, especially the university. Unfortunately, now is the lockdown, but I hope it will be going on in the future so that we all can go also to make an exchange to the UNAC. This is an aerospace university with the airport in the near, and they built airplanes in composite, and they have a lot of machines and CNC machines there. So I see that the students have a lot of skills, and I wish you good luck for your team. Unfortunately, maybe the next year the participation will also not be possible. We don't fly. We know it now. And but we have the time to make our rover completely different and also to upgrade him with electric power for a next challenge, what we will have in the future here in Germany for green power engines. So Shafi, you are back again. This is nice. Alina also, Yvonne. So now we have a young boy who is asking me, he want to show his 3D printed CAD drawn pieces. This is Jesku. Jesku, bist du da? So, dann zeig mal, was du gemacht hast.
Ich habe das das funktioniert. Iron Violet Santa Claus and the Claus. I'm a Drohne.
This is his drone. He made a drone by himself, completely by himself on SolidWorks.
Yes.
And this. So this is a wagon from a train.
And I'm a Flugzeug.
This is an airplane as a cookie cutter, so to press cookies with it. No?
Einmal eine Drohne.
This is his second drone, version 2, with propellers. With propeller, nice. Okay.
Oh,
so, hast du noch was?
Yes.
So the last one comes now.
Einmal hier.
No. There is a hole for the battery inside. Yeah. This is from the Star Wars Sphero.
This
ice. Oh, and this is from Tara, a Christmas tree.
And this, mine's in
China. Oh, two drones. So we can make a drone activity here together. Okay, thank you, Jesko. Give him an applause. Clap your hands. Okay. So, Jaslene, maybe you can prepare some screenshots from your work, what you are doing with SolidWorks, so that we have a distance from his beginning until that advanced what you are doing. But first, I want to ask Felipe. Felipe, hello. How are you doing? Please introduce yourself.
Hello, everyone. My name is Felipe. I'm from Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. And I've been a space trooper since 2018. And this is my fourth time on the rover challenge.
Okay, Felipe, you made more than the rover challenge. Tell me something about your space camp adventure.
Oh, yeah, of course. I've been in the space camp in 2018, and it was a fortunate experience. It was my first time outside Brazil, and I could meet incredible people with incredible personalities and incredible ideas. It was absolutely fine, and it's an honor to experience this for the fourth time, I guess.
I believe this. Who else was with him in the same team? Hands up, please. Yeah, Cosma? There's Erika. Cosma is left us. Okay, and Firina. And Yvonne was also inside as a team leader. Huh? Okay, that's fine. Okay, you are the one and only now from the Space Troopers, the legendary Space Troopers, Philippa. And I'm proud to see you here. This is the first test of our video conference. In the future, we want to make more. You see Jesko, what he did on CAT. This we do here. We give CAT units for everyone who is interested in, who want to improve himself. And we have a present. This is a sponsor contract with SolidWorks for everyone who works with us together. License has a cost of 15,000 euro, and you will get it from us so long you were working with us together in the future. That's it. So we have a new member here. This is Erika. Erika is the mother from Valeria. She comes from Mexico City. Hello, Erika, how are you doing? Nice to see you.
Nice to see you as well, Ralph. Yes, I am Erika Zafra. I'm from Mexico. I am Valeria's mother. I am electronics engineer, so these topics on the space are very interesting for me as well. So thank you for doing this, Ralph. Congratulations.
Erika, thank you too. Because for the trust to send your daughter so far around the globe. Unfortunately, she is not on the moon now, but she is here on our globe. Erika, you are from Mexico City. May I please some words in Spain language? We have a lot of Spain people with us here.
Yeah, so it's very good to be here with you, and it's very good to have people from different countries, different culture, different backgrounds. So this is great.
¿Tú hablas español?
Sí, sí hablo español, un poco. I'm bilingual Spanish.
Yeah, maybe Alina, you give us a nice introduction in Spain language that we can hear the Spain again.
Ah, muy bien, muy bien. Bueno, yo soy Erika Zafra, soy de la Ciudad de México, mamá de Valeria, que está ahora en el instituto con Ralph, y mucho gusto estar aquí con ustedes.
Thank you. Everyone understand this? Okay, that's nice. So when I am a little bit absent sometimes, so I make screenshots, I want to make a new screenshot now. Erika, so we make a photo now for the German press. Everyone smile. So I count down. 3, 2, 1, cheese. Okay, this makes fun. Shafi, you have two accounts. Okay, this is nice. So next, there's coming more. Erika is back now. Okay, so a lot of changings now. Navdeep, did we have you on our? Let's see. Navdeep is also there. That's fine. Okay. So, Jocelyn. Tell us and tell to the other students what you can do with SolidWorks and what you are doing with SolidWorks after Jesko made some simple things with his age of 6 years. What is possible to create a future?
Yeah, sure. So, 1 minute. Can you hear me now properly?
No, yes.
Okay. So, it's a wonderful tool for the designers and especially for the people who are looking into some sort of future in the space industry. It's something like you can say that you imagine something and you can actually bring into the reality. So yes, obviously you cannot go to the Mars and Moon right away, but you can actually design a scaled model of it in the SolidWorks. And so once your model is ready, you can actually do the like the rendering and everything in the SolidWorks, and the model looks very real. You can do the 3D printing of the model, and also using virtual reality and the mixed reality. So once the rover, once your model is ready, you can actually put sub dimensions, and then if the model is actually be ready for the virtual reality as well as the mixed reality. And that's a very wonderful experience for us to have the live experience of it. I can share a few images of what I have worked on. Let's see. how okay, share screen. Ralph, can you make me the host?
Valeria, this is for you. Please give your permission for sharing screen.
Thank you.
You are the host now.
This is very nice. So it is correct.
Okay, so this is in the SolidWorks, and this is the lander from the Dynetics company. It's the scaled model of the lander exactly this way, and this is one of the lander which is selected by NASA for the moon mission. So there are three landers selected. One is from Dynetics, another one is from SpaceX, and the third one is from national team. So this is the first winner of the proposal. So we have used this model and working on this one. And so here are some more pictures. Can you see the another picture?
No, I think you stopped sharing your screen. Maybe you can share it again.
I'm so sorry. Howard, now, can you see the picture now? Oh.
Also in little scale.
Again, your explorer only open this picture.
Okay.
Maybe we start now with a short introduction of Firina. And Jasleen, when you are ready with your gallery, then we can put you again. Oh yeah, you see?
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Nice. That's the interior of the habitat. You can see the astronauts and the glove box, and this is basically the spaceports. And again, you can see that how nicely we can actually design the model inside the inside this software and then render, and this model just looks like an exact thing. And then once it's ready, you can 3D print it, and it's a very useful science model that for your understanding to see whether this can actually work in the future or not. So here is another picture. Do you see this one?
No, we see the same one.
Okay. Okay. Never mind. I will put all them together somehow and see if I can work on that. But I'm so sorry about that. Yeah, you can continue.
Okay. No worries.
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you. We see a lot. And this is the future, what you can do. Valeria, you are our instructor. Everyone learns now from you. And let us show from Verena what you learned in the in only one last lesson. Verena, please.
I can't share my screen.
So, Jasleen, you must. Yes, nice. And now permission for Felina. Thank you.
Now I'm not a host, so I need Jasleen to give permission to Firin to share her screen.
Yes, please.
Thank you. Can you try to share your screen now?
Yeah. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. So as Ralph said, I've only had two lessons so far with Valeria, so I'm still like just in the beginning. So first, of course, we have to start a sketch. And then we can just draw with all the different kinds of pieces. Maybe we want to start a dice or something, so we just draw the first lines. And then we can add some relations, for example. Like the screen is covering some of my heart. Okay, never mind. Like, okay. We can also turn the 2D sketch into a 3D model. This, maybe we want it to be about 50 millimeters. And then we have sort of a cube.
Maybe you can show us the homework that you did this weekend, and you can explain what you did or what which steps you followed.
Sure. I think it's this one. Yeah, so this is the piece that what it was my first homework. So I just got some sketches with the sizes the different parts should be. And then I tried to design it with different sketches. So this part consists of two sketches. One is like this part and the other one is this part.
Beautiful, Farina. Thank you. You all can give her an applause. Yeah, 16 you are now, no?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, 16 years and starting this. And you have enough time to come to the university and they will start with you then, only this CAT program. But you have all time to start now and to be better than when you come into your university. I know that Firina is preparing for a university in Netherlands. Please explain yourself what you want to make in the future.
So I would like to study aerospace engineering in Delft, the technical university there. It's a small town nearby Amsterdam, and they have many special things to like study in this field. They have simulators, flight simulators. They also fly for the study. Yeah, so I think it's really interesting and I would like to study there first. Then I would like to do my master somewhere and work in the space field.
Amazing. Thank you, Verena. Okay, so what is the time now, Valeria? How many minutes we have?
I think we have around 10 minutes.
10 minutes, okay. So the last 10 minutes, these are questions and answers for all of you. So you only need to hold your hands up, can ask questions. We want to make this conversations more intensive in the future. My a bigger video conference will be on Monday with the Innovation Congress of Latin America, where I am a speaker for thousands of teachers of primary, advanced and high schools. This will be held by the Tech Monterrey Institute. So for you, Juan, you will know who is this. No? This is the neighbor. and Shafi, if you want to join this, you all are invited on my Facebook. You see how you can log in. And Felipe, you are also in our team. And how do you like this, what Firine made? Felipe, this is for you. How do you like this, what Firine made now? Do you want to do this also?
Of course.
Okay, do you want to make also CAT in your future?
Oh, yeah. I'm having a connection problem, so I actually not hearing you so well, but I want to do it either.
Okay, we will make this possible because Rafaela is also our student since the last week, and we will do this. Okay, so now it's time for questions. So please ask. You can also ask questions to Jaslin, to Farina, to Felipe, Shafi. You are now not in in Chennai. What did you make after your university? What you are doing now?
So first up, after I graduated, I was the team leader for my team for NASA Rover Challenge. And after I participated in that, then I came here as a graduate student at University of New Hampshire, UNH. So currently I am studying electrical and computer engineering, doing master's. So this is my, I've been here for more than a year. So yeah, so soon I'll be graduating, maybe next year by summer.
Thank you, Shafi. You are one of the best team leaders of India, what I know, and also one of the best mechanics of Southeast India, now in New Hampshire. So I hope we will see you back again in the future with your own team. you can do this also from New Hampshire. This is no problem. You only need an institution what will support you with a team and everything what you need to collect money and to rebuild a team. Also yes. For other competitions, so you will, we will share this with you. Cosma, you are now living in Germany together with the Corona lockdown. Maybe tell us something about your actual life in school. How is this possible?
Since next Monday, we have a lockdown. And this lockdown will go 1 week. And in this
you need to be a little bit louder, Cosma, and come closer. Come closer to the screen.
Okay. Do you can hear me better?
No.
Okay, 1 second.
Okay. Cosma is now at home in her room, and Germany will start with a second lockdown in Monday. So this is over the Christmas time and over Sylvester. So the cases are rising because of a democracy. Everyone wants to have free and freedom. And so we are happy that the vaccine is now on the way to be possible. So Cosma, back again. Okay, we will check this in the future. You see that somebody has a background from ESAI and somebody not. So we found out that the background is possible when you have a desktop computer and with an Android pad or cell phone, a background is not possible. So we share a nice background with the flag upstairs for everyone. You see that here. This is a German flag. Valeria has a Mexican flag and Jasleen has an Indian flag. And so we shared today 15 different flags, but the problem is that the time change is also against us. Maybe Shafi, what is the time now in New Hampshire?
It's noon here, 12:05, so it's daytime.
Okay, Felipe, what is the time in Rio?
2 o'clock.
12 o'clock?
2 o'clock.
2 o'clock. Okay, in the afternoon. Yes, so we have here in Germany, Berlin, Leipzig, we have it at 6 o'clock in the afternoon. Navdeep, what is the time in India?
It is 22.
So this is a big time difference from 12 o'clock to 22. So we must find out which time we need to make a video conference. But I think it is a good idea to make 3 different times a day for 3 different time zones, so that we can connect in everyone in his afternoon, so that we can make our units. Yeah, this is everything for today from me. I'm very happy to see you back again, and invite your friends, invite your team partners, that we are more in the future. We want to repeat this every Friday on 5 o'clock Berlin time, what is now -1 o'clock in your time. So 9 o'clock in India, in 9 o'clock, also at 11 o'clock in New Hampshire. So what I recorded now, and give us hints, give us text when you want to change something, when you want to have another time, so that we can make a timetable, a weekly timetable for our units. We want to make in the future, not only CAD, there comes also electronic, there comes programming, there comes video editing, and also marketing and crowdfunding. So there comes a lot of units to you in the future. And if you, this is special for the order of your students, if you want to make as teacher a course, so you are invited to do that. I am looking forward to have a teacher for space habitat design. Yeah, Jasleen, this is your turn. Why you not make it, do it, and let us sit together. We are working here on the technique that we can record everything and stream online onto Facebook and to WhatsApp, YouTube, and also to Instagram, that we don't need to cut it, that we have it online, live. So, but live people in YouTube cannot participate on our unit, but they can see it and they can join it in the next time. That's why you see here our meeting number upstairs. Yeah? Okay, this was it from me. I wish you all a very nice third advent and a nice weekend. And Erika is here also. Hello. So I say it in German. Ich wünsche euch einen schönen Abend, einen schönen dritten Advent und lassen uns später sehen wieder nächste Woche. So let us see us next week again, and everyone can say his last sentences in his language. Please, Valeria first.
Muchas gracias a todos y nos vemos la próxima semana.
Jasleen?
सबको मिलकर बहुत अच्छा लगा मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट टाइम
ओके वी डिडंट हियर एनीथिंग प्लीज लाउडर जसलीन अगेन
आप सबको मिलकर बहुत अच्छा लगा मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट टाइम
यस थैंक यू शाफी
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया सब लोगों का मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा आप लोगों से मिलके And I hope फिर से मिलेंगे हम जल्दी.
Thank you, Shafi, Felipe.
Muito obrigado a todos e nos vemos na semana que vem.
Thank you, Felipe. Juan?
Muchas gracias por la invitación y bueno, espero verlos la siguiente semana.
Thank you, Juan. Now, Cosma. Okay, thank you, Cosma. You must work on your voice. Navdeep, please.
Fir milange, Cheti.
Oh, this was very short. Thank you. Tara, can you say something in Deutsch? Thank you, Tara. Erika, please. Por favor, Erika.
Buen día a todos. Pasen una excelente semana y hasta la próxima.
Thank you. Hasta la próxima. I understand this too. Muchas gracias. And Yvonne as the last.
So, vielen Dank für das Meeting, für das erste Meeting. Und ich freue mich schon, euch das nächste Mal zu sehen. Macht's gut. Tschüss.
Halt, stopp. Nicht tschüss. Nicht, not tschüss. Firine ist forgotten von mir.
Ja.
Firine, please, you have the last words.
Vielen Dank an alle. Ich freue mich auf das nächste Mal.
Tschüss. Bye-bye. Thank you for coming.